My name is Ionut Mironica, and I am a researcher at Adobe Romania, and today I will present the paper A Generative Adversarial Approach with Residual Learning for Dust and Scratches Artifacts Removal. Photographic materials are rather unstable compared to other cultural objects. The degradation is much faster than those of paintings, sculpture, or architecture. There are several factors that limit the permanence of photographic material. In color material, the dyes bleach with time. In black and white material, the finely spread silver particles are oxidizing and hence discoloring. The film base itself, composed by cellulose, acetate, and nitrate, degrades and shrinks. And in the end, the mechanical wear and abrasion can also produce scratches. The goal of this paper is to investigate a solution for one particular problem, the removal of dust and scratches noise using a deep learning approach. Today, the photographers are using several alternatives. The first one are digitalized scanners, and those represents a hardware infrared technology used to detect dust and scratches on film. While it has proven to be a great tool, it does not work with black and white film and is only available on dedicated hardware while scanning the image. This hardware is either prohibitively expensive and very slow to use. Photoshop currently includes a dust scratches filter that helps to reduce the artifacts by altering the image and making it softer. This method is destructive and it removes sharpness, often making the images unusable. Also, the photographers are using Photoshop Healing and Clone tool, while the artifacts can be individually removed. While this produces great results, it is incredibly slow and requires manual process. In this paper, we propose a dedicated architecture of generative adversarial network, especially address the problem of dust and scratches removal. To our knowledge, this is the first GAN applied to this problem that scales with image resolution and generates no distortion artifacts in the image. We combine a list of novel loss functions that are able to keep visual quality of restored photos. We demonstrate its generality in terms of application, but applying it wide category of images, and we achieve better performance than the state-of-the-art algorithms and applications compared to the mentioned prior art. The generative adversarial network approach is able to work on both black and white and color film. It can remove dust and scratches in a non-destructive way while preserving images sharpness and without adding artifacts. It does not require any manual work, and since it is software based, it can be used on the scanned image no matter the deserialization method used. Inspired by the recent advance in semantic segmentation and GANs, the architecture contains two parts: a generator that represents a feed-forward reconstruction CNN network and a discriminator model. The generated network contains several blocks: input, output, downsampling, upsampling, and dilated residual blocks. The input block receives a color image while the output is bounded by a sigmoid function that normalizes the network output values to 0-1 interval. After the input layer, there is a downsampling layer that reduces the size of the input. It is followed by 7 dilated residual blocks. Each block contains a channel attention mechanism. The feature maps from convolutional layers such that different features are weighted differently according to global statistics of the activations. In order to take information from different scales, the block contains dialect convolutions, which helps the network to reach a global contextual consistency in the spatial domain. Each block uses batch normalization, which has become a common practice in deep learning to accelerate the training of deep neural network. Internally, batch normalization preserves content-related information by reducing the variance shift within a mini-batch during training. It uses the internal mean and variance in the batch to normalize each feature channel. The discriminator is using a batch GAN fully convolutional architecture as proposed in peak-to-peak GAN architecture. The discriminator and the generator operates on the residual between the original image and the median image. This allows both the generator and the discriminator to concentrate only the important sources of noise and be more specific to the dust and scratches artifacts, since these regions are challenging to reconstruct and in painting well, they are corresponding to the larger perceptual errors. This can also be viewed as subtracting a data-dependent baseline, which helps to reduce variance. In our algorithm, we want to reduce the dissimilarity between the approximation image and the correct image while using a weighted sum between the pixel loss and the gradient loss. Also, we want to improve the perceptual quality of the corrected image, for which we have included the perceptual loss and the adversarial loss. The perceptual quality of an image represents the degree to which it looks like a natural image and has nothing to do with its similarity to any reference image. We define the pixel loss as the mean square error, and the gradient loss, we penalize the difference between edges as the difference between the gradient operator along X and Y axis. Metrics such as PSNR and SSIM only focus on low-level information in the image, while it is also necessary to use some kind of high-level information to improve the visual quality. In order to improve the visual quality, we are using the perceptual loss and the vanilla adversarial loss. We set the values of the weights for all the losses to 1 except for the adversarial loss that is set to 0.01. Real corrected images with ground truth are difficult to obtain. To generate enough training data, we adopted a fusion of synthetic noise and real data as for our training data set. Using a set of 2,500 film photos without dust and scratches error, we apply a diverse category of 100 synthetic artifacts. However, because we want to validate our algorithm on real-world scenarios, for test data, we use a set of 500 photos with real noise that were provided and manually corrected by several professional photographers. The first row contains several examples from the training data set. The second row provides synthetic images and some examples from the test data set are provided on the last row. Our implementation is based on PyTorch because we have a reduced number of training photos and their size are higher than 10 megapixels. We have extracted 128 by 128 pages from the training images. We trained the model with 200 epochs using the ADAM optimizer. We decreased the learning rate on each epoch using a standard weight decay, and we set the batch size to a minimum of 32. To prevent overfitting, we perform image augmentation. We apply random transformation to input samples during network training on the fly. we apply random rotation and resizing transformation on both input image and syntactic errors. Also, you applied random intensities on the synthetic images. In order to evaluate our method, we used peak signal to noise ratio, PSNR, and the structure similarity index parameters. We compare our method with other deep learning architectures like the GAN-based method PIX2PIX and the method proposed by David Strubel that contains a network inspired from the SegNet. For a fair comparison, we fine-tune this model on our training dataset. Also, we compare our method with the algorithm presented in Adobe Photoshop that is able to generate automatic dust and scratches removal. The table summarizes the results of all competing methods on our test dataset. As it can be seen, the proposed model obtains better results than other methods in terms of PSNR and SSIM index. Our method obtains a PSNR of 35.12 and a SSIM value equal to 0.92. The difference between the proposed approach and other algorithms are considerable. Let's consider the following input image. PIX2PIX is not able to remove most of the artifacts. You can see more details in the red rectangles. The architecture inspired from the SegNet network removes the artifacts but generates color artifacts because it is not suitable for color images. The algorithm from Photoshop it is also able to remove most of the artifacts, but the generated image become blurry and many relevant details are removed from the last generated photo. So to conclude, using the proposed model, it significantly improves the PSNR and the SSIM, yielding much better results than other algorithms. The next slides, I will present you some results on black and white images. Also, some results with color images. In this work, we presented a new method that improves the state-of-the-art for automatic dust and scratches removal on film photos using an adversarial network approach. The proposed method integrates techniques from the literature to ensure good training stability and to increase the contribution of adversarial loss during training, which prevents the GAN from collapsing into blurry images. The main contribution of the paper are the design of the method for the restoration of dust and scratches artifacts, the introduction of a benchmark dataset that creates a realistic scenario to test the proposed system, and a comparison with state-of-the-art algorithms and software applications. Preliminary results with the proposed architecture show good results for the restoration of other artifacts like noise removal and digital dust. And as future work, we plan to investigate its extension to other single and multiple distortions. Also, we want to extend our research to old film videos, which can improve temporal information regarding dust and scratches. Thank you for your attention.